Recessions damage the economy, and to characterize their costs, macroeconomists have typically focused on the impact on consumption. This paper asks whether economic slowdowns also affect another important outcome, health. To what extent do recessions impact mortality rates, and how does this shift our understanding of their overall welfare consequences? The focus is on the 2007 to 2009 Great Recession in the US. At the time, the Great Recession produced the largest decline in U.S. employment since the Great Depression, with the average national unemployment rate increasing by 4.6 percentage points. This overall impact, however, masks substantial differences at the local level, and the authors leverage this spatial variation to estimate the recession's effect on mortality. They compare pre- and post-recession age-adjusted mortality rates in commuting zones, or CZs, that were more or less exposed to the recession, in order to estimate the impact of a 1 percentage point increase in local unemployment rates on local mortality rates. There is wide variation in local mortality immediately before the recession, and, importantly, this spatial variation is uncorrelated with subsequent exposure to the recession. The key finding is that the Great Recession substantially reduced mortality. This figure shows that pre-recession, mortality rates were trending similarly in CZs that were subsequently more versus less exposed to the unemployment shock. But with the onset of the recession, places that were harder hit economically experienced an immediate and pronounced decline in mortality, which then remained at this lower level for at least 10 years. For every 1 percentage point increase in a CZ's unemployment rate between 2007 and 2009, its age-adjusted mortality fell by 0.5%. This implies that an increase in the unemployment rate of the magnitude of the Great Recession reduces the average age-adjusted mortality rate by 2.3% for at least 10 years. Put another way, the Great Recession provided 1 in 25 55-year-olds with an extra year of life. Strikingly, these effects are entirely concentrated among the half of the population with a high school degree or less, but they are otherwise pervasive across demographic groups. There are no meaningful differences by gender or race, and the declines appear across many causes of death, with the single largest cause of death, cardiovascular mortality, accounting for roughly half of the estimated decline. And while there are similar percentage reductions in mortality across age groups, because mortality is much higher among the elderly, about 3/4 of the overall mortality reduction comes from averted deaths among those ages 65 and older. What explains these declines? The fact that averted deaths are concentrated among the elderly, who, being out of the labor market, experienced little to no direct effects from the rise in unemployment, suggests that the primary driver is externalities arising from the reduction in aggregate economic activity. In particular, recession-induced declines in air pollution appear to play an important role. Counties that were harder hit by the Great Recession also experienced larger declines in pollution, and the timing of these effects matches that of the decline in mortality, with both appearing immediately and persisting through the end of the study period. To benchmark the quantitative importance of this channel, this figure shows that netting out each county's pollution shock reduces the estimated impact of the Great Recession on mortality by about 20%, and other complementary approaches suggest that pollution declines may even explain all of the mortality decline. So, how do these results affect our understanding of the welfare consequences of recessions? To explore this, the authors augment a baseline macroeconomics model in which recessions increase the probability of lower income, and therefore lower consumption. Motivated by their findings, they add to this framework the fact that recessions also lower mortality rates. This figure shows the results of this exercise and plots for each model the estimated welfare cost of recessions for people starting at different ages between 35 and 75. So, for example, this point indicates that in the baseline model, a 35-year-old would be willing to pay 2.36% of their average annual consumption for the rest of their lives to avoid the risk of all future recessions. This willingness to pay declines with age, since older people have fewer years remaining, and therefore fewer periods in which there is a risk of recession. Accounting for mortality effects reduces the welfare cost of recession at all ages, and more so at older ages. This is due to the fact that while recessions lower the mortality rate by roughly the same percentage across all age groups, this produces a larger percentage gain in life expectancy at older ages. In fact, the strength of the effect is such that beyond a certain threshold, the augmented model indicates that recessions are actually welfare improving. There are also distributional effects. Recessions typically have a greater negative impact on the consumption of those with less education, but recall that the estimated mortality declines are also entirely concentrated among this population. This implies that mortality effects may mitigate the regressive nature of recessions, and, indeed, this figure shows that in the baseline model, the welfare costs of recessions are substantially higher for those with less education, but the pattern shifts once we incorporate recession-induced declines in mortality. The welfare costs of the less educated are now uniformly lower relative to the baseline, and as individuals age, the impact of lower mortality becomes so large that it closes and ultimately reverses the finding that recessions are more costly for those with less education. Thus, this paper sheds light on the mortality impact of recessions. These findings do not constitute a comprehensive analysis of the welfare impacts of recessions, but they nonetheless highlight the quantitative importance of recession-induced effects on health. More broadly, the paper also speaks to a trade-off between economic activity and mortality, thereby adding to existing arguments that GDP is an incomplete proxy for welfare. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on the Great Recession, the relationship between the economy and health, and the welfare cost of business cycles.